Hi, I'm Peter from URender, and in this video I will talk about contrasts. This is the second of two tutorials regarding this topic, so if you haven't seen the first one, you can watch it here. In art, quality means the saturation of a color, so high saturated colors are referred to more quality. In some cases, you will have a very low tonal and color contrast, and if it's not possible to change these, you also can use a variation of saturation to increase the contrast of objects or areas. You also know this concept from nature when you think about high saturated fruits, flowers, or animals. The quantity contrast describes the amount of different sizes colors visually have in the image. In this case, it is important that warm and bright colors like red, orange, and yellow are dominating darker, colder ones. So, if it is the goal to get a balanced appearance, the darker and colder ones need to be applied on larger areas. Here I have set some colors as cubes and distributed them depending on the visual balance. The greatest adjustment has to be made if using yellow and purple. We need a little less adjustment for orange and blue, and red and green can be applied in the same amount. On the bottom, I have distributed the amount of colors in a grid, and especially the yellow color on the right example seems to be too much. On the left side, it looks much more balanced. But the colors also influence themselves, and this brings me to the next kind of contrast. Again, colors are influenced by their surrounding colors. In this example, the flowers have the same color, but the right one looks more emissive. This is very important regarding brightness, so always keep in mind when changing your background from bright to dark, your objects will appear differently. But this contrast is not only about values, it also appears when having complementary colors that are directly placed next to each other. One of the most stunning optical illusions that always forces me to use the color picker is the checkerboard illusion, and you can reproduce it very easily. Create two cubes and use a cloner to create a checkerboard. Assign two materials and set it to a brighter and darker gray. Also, disable reflectance and deactivate the environment map in the render settings, so that we have pure solid colors. Next, create a cylinder and place it on one side. Then create a null object with an infinite light and set the shadow color to 15%. Would you believe that these two tiles have exactly the same color? If you don't believe me, render it to the picture viewer, and when I use the color picker by pressing the command button, you see that this is indeed the same color. Another good example is this. Here I have a ring with a rainbow gradient, and a second one with the exact same gradient, and that is a bit larger, so it is shown a few pixels in the background. If rotating the rings with different speeds, it seems that the thickness of the ring is changing. Remember, this is because different color hues look larger than others. The conceptual contrast defines more what is shown and depends on the ideas in the image. So all other kinds of contrasts I have told you so far can support a conceptual contrast for the best effect. A common topic is to have technical and natural elements in your scene, or old versus new or young. Also, the combination of things that are not combinable in real life are a good way to attract the viewer's attention. Such things are often exciting and interesting to watch. I hope you like this miniseries about contrasts and that this helps you to better understand the effect of different colors. Now get inspired and create your own contrasts. Have fun with your render. Thanks for watching.